good evening, wherever you are. Tom here in my patio, on my patio, behind the counter, in front of, behind food with lovely Katrina and Dugan coming at you one more time. This would be show number 14. Number 14. This is our 14th show right here at our house. Thank you so much for joining us. It's another Sunday early evening, late afternoon. Temperature was quite enjoyable today. It was quite enjoyable. It's probably about 80 degrees, I guess. It's been hot around here, but things are cooling off a little bit. That's where we're at. Same thing. Not much has changed in the last week.
Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday. Tomorrow, maybe some of you are going back to work. Maybe some of you aren't, depending on what you do and where you live and how you live. None of my business. But anyway, the main thing is you are here. Welcome all of our new viewers. Welcome any of our old viewers. Just welcome to all our viewers and watchers and followers of Real Food Live. So, kind of a special night tonight. I mean, they're all special, but this recipe we're going to be making tonight is going to pretty much take up the whole show because there's a couple components to it. I don't know if you guys have ever had turkey pot pie, chicken pot pie. You can go to a couple restaurants in town that serve them. They're okay. But we're going to show you, a lot of times people are intimidated. They think it might be too difficult for them to make. So we're going to simplify the turkey pot pie or chicken pot pie. The thing is, these are really good to make after, like, say, for instance, Thanksgiving. If you have turkey on Thanksgiving, you have a lot of leftover turkey, make some pot pies. A good way to get rid of that turkey. And they're oh so good. Are you having your own little party over there? Something happening over there I should know about or no?
Dave Carlos says, old viewers, you mean me? And Ron said, Tom is special.
Dave and Ron are in the house.
Yeah, easy cue.
And easy too. So, wow, so there we go. So we have our core audience here tonight. And that's really all we need. If anyone else trickles in, doesn't matter. Because basically, I found out I'm doing my show on a regular basis for Ron, Dave, and Easy. And sometimes Tara that might jump it in. And Louise, don't want to forget about Louise. Louise is probably... And Diane is there too, another regular viewer from... What city does Diane live in? I keep forgetting.
Henderson. I think it's... No. Shoot.
You don't know. No. Okay. It doesn't matter. Anyway, she's up north around, I think, where the fires are, right?
Right, Fresno.
Fresno. Yeah, so it's kind of smoky up there, I think, right about this time of year with all the fires and everything. But what do I know? I've been in the house for the last 6 months. I don't get out. So anyway, we're going to make some chicken pot pie, turkey pot pie. Tonight we're going to be making chicken pot pie because What's that?
Hanford.
Thank you so much. Also, we're going to be having a little bit of a question and answer period at the end of the show. So if you have any questions, just go ahead and type them in now. Let Katrina know. And then if we have some time at the end of the show, we'll kind of go through any questions you might have. It could be pertaining to food. It could be pertaining to me, Katrina, the dog, Ron, Dave, whatever questions you might have about anything, anybody. Doesn't even have to be food related. We're just here to give you the information, no matter what that might be. So... here's what we're going to do. We're going to make a chicken pot pie with a celery seed pastry pie crust. Oh so good, okay? And oh so easy too. But you're going to love this. I love this. I love the chicken pot pie. I make a bunch of them. I throw them in the freezer and pull them out and eat them whenever I want, okay?
Tara's in the house.
Tara Preston is in the house.
Yeah, she said I'm the youngest old viewer.
That's right. And Tara eats healthy. You know, I don't think she eats... I don't know if this would even, if she would even like a chicken pot pie, but she is here, maybe not for the food, maybe just for the entertainment, maybe just to see what Ron and Dave are doing. I don't know. But the main thing is she is here. Welcome, Tara. So anyway, this is probably, I got to be honest, not as healthy as a salad, but then not as bad as maybe a deep fried cheese. Okay, so somewhere in the middle. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off, we have our pan getting warm here. We're going to first of all put in a third of a cup of butter. So if you buy your butter, you just take a stick here, and they have a little measuring thing on the side here. It tells you tablespoons, cups, quarter cups. So all you got to do is cut on the line, okay? Very simple, okay? So we're going to go, it's a third of a cup a third of a cup. We're going to give a third of a cup of butter, okay? And that's a lot of butter. It really is. We're going to be making four chicken pot pies. It's going to yield four chicken pot pies. So we're going to put that right in there like that. Okay, so you can see the pan was warmed up. And the butter is a melting already. See, it's a melting. Okay, so this is simple. What we're going to do to that, we're going to put in like a third of a cup of chopped onions. You can also, a lot of recipes, you'll get chicken pot pies, they will have they'll use what they call pearl onions. You ever seen those, Katrina, little pearl onions?
Yeah.
You can buy those in a can.
They're okay.
I tried them before, they're little tough, that they're hard to chew on, you know. So I prefer just a diced onion like this, because that's the way Tom's rolling tonight on Sunday. I just feel like a little bit of chopping, not a lot of pearl, just a little bit of chopping. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Onion,
okay.
Yeah.
So anyway, keep an eye on this heat too, because you don't obviously want to burn your butter. That's not a good thing. So take that all the way down on low. Then once that all melts, you're going to throw your onions in, just kind of saute them up a little bit. Okay?
Can I jump in?
Jump right in.
Dave Parla says, I don't eat chicken pot pie. Louise and I are here for the laugh and to see what Ron has to add to the show.
Dave doesn't like chicken pot pies? I hope that's not true. Maybe Dave's not a meat eater. I'm not sure about that.
He likes salmon.
They like salmon. You know what? We need to do a salmon.
Yes.
We need to do a salmon show for Dave.
Yep. Yep.
We'll do a salmon and turkey croquettes.
Like three different ways to make salmon.
Salmon and turkey croquettes for Dave and Louise. It would be a special little show for them because they have not missed a show, I don't think. They have not missed a show. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if that's something I'd be bragging about or not. But the main thing is, you know, he's here. We don't want to disparage, you know, all of our loyal followers, because that wouldn't be good. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to get this thing going here and cook your onions. We're going to put a little bit of salt in here, like this.
Louise likes chicken pot pie, and he says he loves salmon. And then Ron says, jump in, Katrina, we need you on camera. No, thank you!
Katrina's not much of a camera person. She doesn't like being... She's more BTS, behind the scenes. Okay, that's what she does best, behind the scenes. Okay, so as you can see, now right there, you got to be careful, because I just got a piece of the paper from the butter in there.
Ew.
Which, you know, it's not going to hurt you, but it is kind of embarrassing if you have guests over and you go, what is this?
And better than hair.
What's that?
It's better than hair.
It's better than hair, that's true. And we've had both, I think. So anyway, so you take the paper out, and yeah, it's always good to, you know, to pay attention when you are cooking. Just see what's floating around in your food, because things could fall from the sky or from your hair or, you know.
A fly.
I mean, I remember I was working in a restaurant one time, and I had a Band-Aid on my finger, and I was there working an hour, and like about an hour after that, my Band-Aid wasn't on there anymore. I don't know what happened to my Band-Aid. Just a little human interest story I thought I'd throw in there. You know,
Ron said she's extremely vocal, BTS.
Great. Okay.
Behind the scenes.
Okay, so. Sorry. So anyway, we just have, you can see, I mean, not much happened here, right? It's just sauteed onions, chopped onions and some butter, okay? Not much excitement right now. So I'm going to put those in there. Let's crank this up really high. So then what we're going to do to that, we're going to add some flour, okay? So basically what we're going to do here is we're making a roux, but it's going to be just your basic white sauce is what we're going to end up making here, okay? So we're going to put in a third of a cup of flour, like this. Shit's flying all over the place. Okay, when you do that, this is going to get all thick real quick. Thick and quick. It's going to get thick quick, okay? So I'm going to try to be a little bit neater this time. Sometimes I kind of get a little nutty here, and food just goes flying all over the place. So I'm going to try to keep it a little bit clean tonight. I think I might be able to do that. So anyway, so there you go. So there's your flour, and you can see just a basic roux. Not much right now. I don't want to eat this. It would taste like crap. But it's just flour and butter and your chopped onions. And you're probably thinking to yourself, Tom, how is this ever going to turn into anything that I would even want to put in my mouth, you know, let alone serve my friends and guests? Well, it's going to happen. It's going to happen right before your eyes. And when I put this, I've got some chicken stock and I got some milk here. Once I add that in there, this whole thing is just going to change. It's kind of like a caterpillar and a butterfly. Okay, this is kind of like the caterpillar right now. And once I add all the liquid, it's going to turn into a beautiful butterfly, a pot pie butterfly, if you will. Okay, so there you go. So it doesn't look like much now, just a bunch of crumpled flour. cheese. I hope this turns out. Okay, so what we're going to do now, I have some chicken stock. Okay, you can use turkey stock too. But I'm going to put this in. This is 2 cups. I'm going to put that in there just like that. Okay, you're going to let that cook and cook and cook and cook. Okay, hopefully it'll cook faster than what it is. And then just kind of give it a stir. Best thing to do for at this point is use a little bit of a whip. You don't want it to get lumpy, okay? And the good news is we do have one. I made a bunch of these earlier in the day, so we're going to actually have a finished one and try it when we're at the end of the show. So we will see how this turned out. So I made pot pies earlier today, and I'm making them now. So we're going to have about 8 pot pies floating around this damn house
here. Yay!
Are you happy about that?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so you starting to thicken up now, obviously. So to that, what we're going to do now, what's that? You got to share, Katrina. Just consider, just sitting over there laughing to yourself is kind of creepy.
Ron said, someone wake up Dave.
Okay, so it still looks thick, right? Well, that's because we didn't put in our milk. So we're going to put in, a cup of milk. I think it's a cup of milk. Three quarters of a cup of milk going right in there like that. 3/4 of a cup of milk. Okay. So, this is something you can do if people come over. You just want to hang out in the kitchen. I mean, you can talk to your friends and family as you're doing this. You don't have to be stuck in the kitchen. They can even help if they want. They can do stuff. Like, I don't know what they could do.
Can I just say Ron is on fire?
Ron's on fire?
Yeah.
Really?
He said pot pie party.
Okay. So the main thing is you don't want to have this super, super thick, but you don't want to have it like water either. And we've all had pot pies, so you know the consistency when you bite into a pot pie, what they are. They're not all runny all over the place. It's just kind of like a gravy. Now I'm looking at this going, this still might be a little thick. I'm going to have to get some more melt going in here. Here, Katrina, you want to just put some in here? Big round of applause for Katrina. There she is, working hard. Katrina, thank you so much. Yep. So, this is really a lot thicker than tastes good though. Okay. So yeah, I don't know why is it so damn thick now? Did I use too much flour?
I don't know.
There go a cup of flour. Yeah. Oh, you know what? I did.
What?
I used way too much milk. Okay, our first screw up.
You want some more milk?
I was supposed to use 1/3 of a cup of... Okay, let's rewind now. About 1/3 of a cup of flour.
And you use a cup?
And I use a whole cup. Okay, so I'm way over.
Pour all the milk in.
But that's okay. It's...
Jill Sapp is watching.
Who?
Sorry, Jill.
That's why it's thick. Okay, I'm looking at this going, I just made this a couple hours ago. And it wasn't this thick. So,
oopsie.
But that's okay. Because you know what? Well,
you want some more milk?
I'm thinking taking some of the shit out of here, maybe. Scooping it out.
Just put more milk in.
Huh?
Just put more milk in. You'll be fine.
Well, I know, but the more you dilute it, the less it's going to taste like chicken. Still good, though.
Is it too thick? Do you want some more milk?
Well, it's still thick, yeah.
You want more?
A little bit here.
Not the whole thing.
bring in the whole damn cow. Okay, so anyway, this is not, if you would make the same mistake, it's not the end of the world. As a matter of fact, all you would do is end up with a little bit more pot pie filling, huh?
Yeah, it's still going to be good.
Yeah, it's still going to be good. You're just going to end up with a little bit more pot pie filling, but you know what? That doesn't matter because you can freeze it or just fill the pot pies up a little bit more.
Denise Stiebel says, add more chicken stock. And Carol Michella looks yummy. I'm hungry.
Yeah. Okay, so we're back on track now, sort of, kind of.
Oh my gosh.
What happened?
Ron.
Okay.
So many inappropriate thickness jokes.
Okay, so that's good. It still has retained its taste. Oh, shit. Let's put a little bit more milk in, just be on the safe side, and we'll kind of go on to the next step. Okay, so more milk in there. If I had more chicken stock, I would add more chicken stock, but I don't, so I can't. But that's okay. You get the idea.
I can make you some.
The The recipe is right down below there, the one that you should be making, not the one that I'm making, obviously. Okay, so what we're going to do, we got that all kind of, it's all nice and creamy there. It's like a nice, beautiful, I don't know what the word is I would even call this. It's just a beautiful blend of everything. A shitload of flour, I'll say that. But, okay, so there we go. So now all you have to do is you want to add your, we're going to have peas and carrots. If you want to use fresh carrots, you can do that as well, but these are frozen. 6 ounces of each. They're going to go right in there like that. And it's a beautiful thing. I mean, that's very colorful right now. And on top of that, 2 cups of your chicken or your turkey, whatever you're going to add to that. It's all in there right now. I wish you could see this close-up of this because this is a beautiful thing. So then what you want to do is you just want to take a little spoon here, just kind of stir it around a little bit and let that cook. Okay? And this is what's going to be going in your pot pie. Okay? So this is step one. Make this ahead of time, then just let it simmer around for a little bit. You know, quite honestly, you can throw this on a waffle or some mashed potatoes and be done with it, too.
Okay? Mashed potatoes would be good.
Mashed potatoes would be beauteous. Okay? So, there you go. Hi, Dugan. How you doing, buddy? You want some chicken pot pie? It's my dog down here. You can't see him, I don't think. But
he's looking.
Just waiting for something to fall on the ground. Right, Dugan? I know.
He has a good sniffer.
I know. How's that sniffer doing? Okay, so we're going to just kind of let this go. Not think too much about it. But at the same time, you don't want it to burn. Okay? So, now we're going to make the celery seed crust that goes with this. And this is what really makes it. And it's a basic pie crust, but the celery seeds is the secret ingredient. And you would think, well, it's not going to really taste like much. But you know what? You can really, just a hint of the celery just makes it really, really good. Okay? So we're going to start off with 2 cups of flour. Just
use
basic.
All your flour.
Huh? Oh, I use all my flour in this. So we're going to start with the 2 cups of flour. Let me just double check that to make sure I'm on the same page with the, 2 cups of flour. 2 cups of flour there. Okay. There's one. And here comes another one. What do you want, Dugan? What do you want? And there's two cups of flour. Okay. And it's starting to bubble a little bit, so you want to keep an eye on that, keep it down. Like I said, if you guys have any questions regarding any of this, we're going to be doing a little Q&A at the end if we have time. So just go ahead and pop them in the comment bar there, and Katrina will try to sort through them and pick out anything she thinks is important. Okay, so we have 2 cups of flour. To that, we're going to add 2 teaspoons. That's what I forgot, the celery salt. How could I forget the celery salt? It's sitting right up above the oven. I thought I had all my shit together, but obviously I did not. But, you know, that happens. You know what? A lot of stuff goes on around here, and that's just one of them. So we got
you
our...
You want celery salt or celery seed?
Celery seed. Celery seed. Okay? And so you got 2 teaspoons of celery seed.
Is there such a thing as celery salt?
Yeah. There's celery salt and celery seed. Oh. You know when you smell this? You know what it smells like? Celery. Smells like celery if... But you know, that's an interesting question is, where do celery seeds come from? Because when you buy celery, where would a seed come? And they're like little tiny things.
Yeah, they don't like come off the celery.
Yeah, it's not like they fly. Well, maybe they flower at the end? Oh, that's a good question. Does anyone know where celery seeds come from? I have no idea. Okay?
Did
the timer go off yet in the oven, Katrina?
No, not yet. Okay. 5 minutes.
Okay, so we have our celery seed, we have our flour. Let's put a little bit of salt in here. Okay? Now you want to get your pastry cutter, right here is a pastry cutter.
Tara says, can you use canned peas?
You what?
Tara says, can you use canned peas rather than frozen?
Can you use canned peas? You can, but why would you want to? They're pretty gnarly. I grew up on canned vegetables, and plus they're kind of soft to begin with, so I think if you put them in a pot pie and bake them, I think they all get kind of mushy and stuff, so I'd use the frozen ones if at all possible.
Or fresh.
Or fresh peas. Yeah, you could do that too. Then you have to like break them all apart and do all that. That's a lot of work, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the only thing we want to do to that now, we want to add our shortening. We're going to add this. This is Crisco oil. You know the Crisco that you buy like in those round things? It's got the blue label on the outside. Well, this is the same thing, but they use it a lot for baking. It's got the same thing, the measurements on the side, right? So we're going to do 2/3 of a cup of this. 2/3 of a cup plus 2 tablespoons. So that's right about there. Okay. And we're just going to fold that into this thing here, and I'll show you how we're going to make our pie crust. This is like so amazing and so damn
good.
You're
going to cut it in, not I'm gonna fold cut it in.
I'm going to cut it in. Thank you, Katrina. See, Katrina watches all the food shows and shows. She knows all the terms. I know what I'm doing. I just don't know what it's called, you know, which happens a lot in my world. So anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to take this. Probably the easiest way to work with it is just cut it down the middle. And you want to put it in like little pieces, okay? Easier to work with. Right, and just throw that whole thing in there. Put it in little pieces, okay?
We need to get the boys a couple of these.
Yeah, I know. Everybody wants some. Okay, so now we take our pastry cutter, and we just kind of mix this all together. Now, if you don't have one of these, you could use a fork, too. But, you know, when you're in the business, like me, I have one of these, and it works perfect. It just kind of, you want to kind of mush this all around like this, so it's just like the dough turns into like a little pea size, the shortening and the flour all kind of mesh together and look like little pea size things. So you do that, and then once you do that, turn this down here. That's good though, man. That is perfect.
Need some more milk?
No, but it is looking good. I will say that.
Yeah, can you turn it down?
Huh?
Me and you.
Okay.
Tom needs to go on Chopped. I agree, Tara.
So, so here we go. The pieces. Now what you want to do is just add a little bit of water, like 5 tablespoons of water, just a couple tablespoons at a time, just to kind of get this a little moist, as they say in the cooking world. Okay? So, you don't want to make it like it's a big old wet ball of dough. But by doing it this way, it just keeps it, the crust will be a little bit flaky. What? Did you know that? Why, are you learning something?
Yeah, that's good the way you do that.
I know.
You don't measure, you just pour it in. I like that.
Yeah, I know. That's hot, huh? I don't measure.
You read my mind.
Yeah. I'll put a little bit more in, and then we're going to be done with that. Okay? I'm going to turn this off because that's bubbling, and I don't care. So, the one in the oven is almost ready though, right?
Yep.
Okay. Was it turning brown at all on the top?
Oh, it was beautiful.
Was it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's all I want to know. I'll make sure it's beautiful. Okay. So, that's pretty well mixed. So, here's what we're going to do. We're going to put this in a ball. One big ball of dough. Okay? You follow me? So, keep in mind, we're going to make... This yields 4 pot pies. Okay? We're only going to put one together tonight, so you get the idea, okay? But this yields 4 pot pies. So we're going to do a little bit of math here, okay? So strap yourselves in, because it might get a little dicey right now as we start doing some math. But this is the best way I found to make sure you have enough crust for every one of your pot pies. Okay, so let's stop and think about this for a second. We're going to make them 4 pot pies. So what we want to do first of all, got my little scale here. Very important. I think everyone should have a scale if you cook at all. Okay, put it to ounces. Okay, so first we're gonna weigh this dough. Okay, gonna weigh the dough. About 17 ounces. Okay, so what we're gonna do, half of 17 is 8.5 ounces, right? So let's do 8.5 and 8.5. Okay. And the thing is, you wanna try to be as precise as possible because you don't wanna get down to the last pot pie, not have enough dough for the crust. So there you go, that's about 8.6 and 8.4, good enough. So let's make it perfect. Okay, so you want 4 pot pies, so let's go take this in half, okay? So half of 8.5 would be about 4 and a quarter. So let's go 4.2 here maybe. 4. There you go, 4.2, 4.1, okay? So let's do this again. 8.4, so let's go about 4.2 on that. Okay, you guys follow me? You follow me on this? Well, that's beauty. 4.2, there you go, perfect. Okay, so now here we go. So we have our 4 pot pies right here. But the thing is, we have 4 pot pies we're going to make, but every pot pie has a shell or a crust that's on the inside, Then they have a crust that goes on the top. So what we have to do now is we have to take these and put these in half. Okay, so you follow me. Four pot pies, each one gets a top and a bottom, so these have to be halved. Okay, so we'll do it here. This is going to be about two. Okay, so there's that. Do this one here. 4.2, let's go 2.1. It's just so much fun. Okay, let's do this again. 4.2.1.
Ron says, I hate it when restaurants put a layer of dough over a bowl of soup and call it pot pie.
Who does that?
Well,
where does Ron go?
A lot of people.
Where does Ron go?
Well, I mean, probably people do that.
They put a
yeah, they make soup.
Like
and
what?
Then just put a thing of a crust on top.
Well, you know, some of the places Ron eats, though, I mean, he's taken us to some of those places. I'm not surprised, you know. I mean, if you see where Ron eats, right? No?
I don't know.
I don't know either. I just made it. I thought it might be funny. Okay, so here we
Ron
go.
Ron said juggle the dough.
That's a job for Bob the Clown.
And Ron said riveting.
Okay, so there we go. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8. 8 dough balls, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4 pot pies. Okay, easy, right? Okay, now comes the fun part. You guys are gonna love this. In fact, I'm getting excited just thinking about it, okay? And wait, you see this. Now, normally when I first started making these, I would roll the dough out with a rolling pin. But check this out.
Oh, you have something new?
I have something new.
Oh.
Something I'm repurposing.
I'm intrigued.
Something that we have at our house, I'm repurposing.
No.
And if Easy is still watching, he's going to really be impressed.
Why would you see that?
What's that?
Why would you see that?
Well, because you'll see. It's a tortilla maker. It's a tortilla. Oh, wow, what's wrong with that?
Because Easy Q is what, Latino?
I think Hispanic, right? I'm just getting back to my Mexican roots here.
Okay. We love you, Easy Q.
That's not a slam. I mean, it's just like,
I know.
Okay. Don't start causing shit
it's
between
me and
Easy.
It's a stereotype.
Just don't, huh? Yeah, it's a stereotype. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. Get yourself a little bit of wax paper. Okay, like I said, we're just going to do one of these here. Unless we have to only do one because we ran out of dishes. I made so many damn pot pies today. Okay, so we're going to take this.
That's a good idea, Tom.
What?
Doing it in the tortilla thing.
Why no?
Yeah,
I know. Sometimes
that's really a good idea.
Well, wait till you see what happens after this.
Oh wow!
Yeah.
Stop it.
I know. Okay, so put a piece of wax paper there. Let's take another one on here. And the reason we're going to do this, obviously, so it doesn't stick to your tortilla maker.
Press.
Tortilla press. That's what I was looking for. Okay. So there we go. So here's what we're going to do. You take one of your dough balls. Well, first of all,
And Diane says, I'm offended. Diane Sanchez.
Okay, so here's what you want to do. You want to go to the store and you want to buy one of these Pyrex two cup dishes. They got to be oven safe. You don't want them to break when you put in there. And they also come with a lid. You can get them at the grocery stores, Walmart, Target, wherever you buy your kitchenware. Two cups. If you get this size two cups, you'll be able to make four perfectly equal in size pot pies. Okay, so remember that, and you'll see why in a second. So anyway, we have our bowl. You just burp?
No, I coughed.
Oh, you coughed. That was
a
burp. Sound like a burp.
That's Dugan.
Okay, Dugan. Okay, so roll in the ball. Okay, check it out. This is a dough ball right here, and. It smells a little bit like celery because it does have the celery seeds in there. I didn't put a lot in, just enough to give it a... Man, that's beautiful. Did I make that?
Uh-huh.
Holy shit, that's beautiful.
I know, right?
I know. So we're going to put this in here. Put this on top. Give it a little push. Take that. Flip it over. And like I said, you could do it with a rolling pin, but why? I mean, this is the perfect size that you want. Okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to take our bowl... Like this. So this is not like those restaurants that Ron goes to where they have the soup with the crust on top. So there it is, perfect, just like a tortilla.
We need to make tortillas with that.
Well, we tried it. The problem was they were coming out kind of thick. We weren't getting them as thin as we wanted. Okay, now this is sticking a little bit. And that will happen. But you see, it doesn't matter because you're not going to see this.
Perfect.
Well, not perfect. Oh. But anyway, it's going to go right in there like that. Okay? So you can... Okay? Okay, so you have your shell inside there. Okay, so it doesn't necessarily have to come up the side because you're going to have so much crust between that and what's on the top that... I need a fork, too.
Oh.
You know what? No, I'll just use my knife. If you had a fork, you know, make your little fork things in there so once it starts cooking, the crust doesn't bubble all up. So anyway, there you go. The crust is in there, not all the way up to the side, but that's okay because the filling's going to go in there and the crust is going to go on top of that. Okay? So,
okay.
What's that?
Okay.
You okay?
No, you said okay.
Okay. So now what we want to do is we want to make, we're going to take our filling, okay? Almonds and...
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Give it a stir. Look at that.
That's thick.
That's thick. Okay, so what we're going to do is just kind of put this right in here, right on the top. Look at that. Right in there. Just fill it up. Like I said, if you do this right, you're going to have exactly enough for four. So fill it to the top. Just like that. Let's take a look at this up close here before I close her up. There it is. It's your pot pie with all the goodness right in there. Carrots, peas, onions. Smells good. It's the perfect consistency. You know, I had to add a little milk because of my screw up. But you know what? No one's gonna know. It's still gonna be good. It's gonna be fine and dandy, beautiful. So put that in there like that. So now all we have to do is make a top, okay? And same way you did it, with one little exception, okay? So let's put that in there like that. Push it down. And how much fun is this? Get the kids all around. The whole family can partake in this, okay? So push it down.
Perfect, oh. Tom. Good idea.
What's that?
Putting that in the tortilla press.
Well, what do you see this part? This is even more impressive. So I just thought of this like the last couple times I made this. So what we do now is we need to cover on here. So if you want to freeze this, well, we'll get to that, but I usually freeze a bunch of these. So what I'm going to do is I'll peel this top layer off here, like this. I'm going to get one of these bowls that we're putting these in. So you got to have a couple extra of these bowls. I'm going to put it right down here like that, right? Push it down. Take my finger.
Oh, no way.
Yeah. I know. I'm pretty excited too. Okay, so you lift it up. Now watch this.
Stop
it. Goes right on the top.
Stop.
Ah. Look at that.
Now, do you brush it with butter or anything like that?
You're going to brush it with
water or egg wash?
Yep. But anyway, look at that. You can see the fit is perfect. I mean, like a glove. I mean, it's beautiful. And you can look down the side there. You got crust all the way down the side. Okay, so then what you want to do is you want to make a little bit of a, not an egg wash, you just take a little bit of egg white and a little bit of water, like I have here already mixed together, just the egg white of the egg, and a little bit of water, get your little brush, just kind of paint it on top, just kind of makes it just kind of shiny a little bit, browns it up, gets it a little bit brown, okay, like that. And then also what you want to do before you put these in the oven, put a little slit down the top. You know what you can do also is if you have extra dough, you can make some little fancy schmancy little design out of dough and put that on top. One time we made like a
leaf.
Heart.
Like
yeah,
a leaf
or something like
yeah.
that. So anyway,
you can use it with the extra dough that you had left over when you...
Sorry.
But
yeah, so what Katrina said, okay? Thanks
Ron
for reminding
said,
me.
Ron said, brilliant.
Yeah. So you can see how everything just fits in this little package, but check this out. So you're going to make four of these, right? Well, maybe you only want to have one or two tonight, so you don't want to eat them like night after night. So that's why you have this lid here that comes with it right on top. If you had the crust going over the outside, you wouldn't be able to do this.
Oh, you're right.
So there you go. So there's your pot pie. stack 1, 2, 3, 4 on top of that.
Oh my God.
It's beautiful, right?
Genius.
So I have 4 out in the freezer now. This makes 5. We're going to have 3 more. So we're going to have like 8 freaking pot pies.
Well, I was going to say, what you should have the crust like going over. Like,
well, you could do that too.
But you're right. You can put the crust, lid on.
Well, you know,
yeah.
there's two thoughts. If I was having people over and I was going to make 4
mm-hmm.
or whatever, I would make it really fancy and have the crust go all over the top.
Yeah.
And all that. But, you know, for these, I'm just going to eat them and I'm going to freeze them, so that's as good as anything.
Good idea.
But I'll tell you, once this browns up and cooks, we just happen to have one that's done here and it's beautiful. The only thing I might need is a fork. But anyway, this is it. And you can see it right there. In fact, I'm going to take a bite of this right here while I'm standing up close. Well, you know what? I have a spoon. Maybe that's even better.
Oh, okay.
But you can see, I put the egg white on there, so it got a little brown. So we're just going to dig in right in the middle. And it, you know, you want, this has been cooling for probably about, what, 15 minutes, 10 minutes?
10 minutes.
So you don't want to eat it as soon as it comes out of the oven, so it's going to be hot. But you put it in for 35 minutes, around 35 minutes at 425. So there you go. So there's the...
Bill Moorhead said, Beverly wants to know if you can make tofu pot pie. I think you can. Yes.
Mmm.
Oh.
This is really good.
Tofu is good.
And a lot of, flavor and a lot of, ingredient. Oh, why that goes down.
Beverly said, looks like creme brulee.
Mm. Oh. So there you go. Chicken pot pie. So... Basically, like I said, turkey, chicken, whatever you want to use. So I have enough here to make 3 more pot pies, which I will probably do that tomorrow sometime.
Oh, my God.
How is it? Good?
Mm.
But you see the celery? You can just taste a little bit of the celery seed. Not too much. It's just there. So this is great. And if you don't have a tortilla press, if you don't have a pastry mixer, you know, you can still do this. But, you know, sometimes these things just make it your life a little bit easier. So anyway, did anyone have any questions? Open it up now. Did anyone have anything along the way? I'm sure Ron probably has a lot to say. Any questions?
Well, Beverly said, can you make it with tofu? And tofu would be great. You just have to flavor it. Like what you would do is...
Well, you have the chicken stock still.
Yeah, you would do that. And you would like just, instead of chicken, you would make tofu.
But now, I'm not...
And flavor it.
Isn't the consistency of tofu kind of soft? I mean, would it like all just...
It can be, but if you I think if you... roast it, it's fine.
But if it's baked in the oven like we did with this for like 35 minutes.
I think it'd be fine.
Okay.
Yeah, it'd
be
good.
Katrina said it's going to be
fine. It'd be really good. We should try that.
Yeah. So substitute tofu if that is your thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have a problem with that. Feel free to change this recipe any way you like, okay?
There is a question.
Oh, there is?
Oh, no, not a question. Ron misses the wind chimes.
Yeah. They're in the trash. We threw those away. We had it. We're done with wind chimes. So, and that's it. Well, 38 minutes tonight. It's a little bit shorter than normal, but you know what? Maybe I talked a little less. We didn't do we only did one meal, okay? But it's kind of
You know what?
What?
I got a hint of that, the celery seed afterwards.
Uh-huh.
It was really good.
It's a gift that keeps on giving.
Yeah.
Yeah, celery seeds. That's right. Wait till you burp tonight. Yeah. It's going to feel like you just jammed a whole stalk of celery down your throat. So anyway, that's it. So we had the filling itself, we had the pie crust, and you know, you could probably use these for this type of crust for other things. I wouldn't use it for like an apple pie or anything, but stuff related to meat, you can probably use a celery pie crust. I'm not sure what for. So anyway, that's it. So we have enough to make 3 more, like I said, and then we're done. We can go to bed by 7 tonight. That's perfect. Hey, dude, come here.
Can I go up there with you guys?
Huh?
Can I go up there?
You want to go up here? Why?
With Dugan?
Well, yeah. If you want to, yeah. I know you want to be on camera. So this is our dog, Dugan, back again. Our partner in crime. We just love this guy. We're putting him up for adoption tonight at 8 o'clock. So if anyone wants him, just email us, and he's yours. We're going to go to the shelter tonight. How would that be, buddy? You can't even hear me.
Yeah.
Anyway, he's a good boy. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Any other questions? Any other questions?
No.
Oh, you want me to leave? Anyway, that's the show. Thank you so much for tuning in, watching, participating. Thank you for your comments, good, bad, or indifferent. I don't care. We're just here to have a good time and to learn a little bit about food. Like I said, the recipes are right down below, or the recipe is right down below there.
Tara said Tom should buy Adele's. I know!
It's been talked about. So, anyway, that's the show, Chicken Pot Pie, a whole show devoted to chicken pot pie. Thank you so much for watching. Show number 14. We'll be back next week. That would be show number 15. Enjoy yourselves. Be nice to each other. Keep on cooking. And until next time, thanks for watching. Good night. Play the closing music.
We don't have any.
Okay. Guess we're done. Good night. See you.